Well, Gamal, it's Russ, and in this video, we're going to be talking about how to convert strings into integers and other types of type conversions. So, something that's very important to understand about variables is how they actually store the data. So if we say x equals the string 1, 2, 3, and we say y equals the integer 1, 2, 3, well, what's the difference between them? Well, we're not going to be able to see it if we print it. If we print x and then we print y, what are we going to see? We're going to see exactly the same output. We're going to see 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to see 1, 2, 3. But what happens if we say print the type of x and then print the type of y? Well, the type of x is going to be class str, and the type of y is going to be class int. So how are they actually stored? Well, when we think about how they're actually stored in memory, the difference between a string and an integer has to do with how we interpret these characters. And so in a string, we view these three numerals as individual entities. They're individual characters. So a string, although it's not the same thing as an array, it's got a heck of a lot of similarities. And what there is in there is there's a character one that's stored first, and then we have character two, and then we have character three. So what you're going to see in memory are literally three different numbers, one representing the character one, the printable character one, one representing the printable character two, the other representing the printable character three. If we changed one of these to something else, to an x, that's no problem at all. We would simply have an x sitting in here instead. All right, so we don't have an x. We actually have the number, or I'm sorry, the character 2. Now, how is this stored? Well, an integer actually represents something that's doing some counting. It holds a numeric value. So there literally is some slot out in memory that holds the number 123. So these are stored very, very differently, even though they print the same. Now, we often find ourselves needing to convert between these two things. If all we're doing is we're printing, nobody really cares. But what if you want to do math? What if we said x plus equals 1. We want to add 1 to this. Well, that's a nonsense operation. Python does not know how to take a string of characters and add an integer to it. That doesn't make any sense at all. And so if you run this code, you will actually get an exception. We'll talk about exceptions later in another video, but right now you'll just, what you should know is that your program will crash. It's not going to work. So what we need to do first is to convert this string into an integer. And Python has a nice convention that says if you want to convert from one type to another, usually the thing you're going to do is that you're going to call a function with that name. We have a string. We want to make it an integer. So we could say int of x. What this will do is that now x is an integer. If we asked to print the type of x, we would get class integer, not class string. Now we can say x plus equals 1. If we print x and then print y, then our output will be that we'll first print 1, 2, 4, we'll print literally the integer 124, then we'll print the integer 123. Does this work the other way around? Yes, you can convert any type you want into a string by simply calling the str function. In the programs that we're going to write in this class, it's not terribly all that useful. Normally, the only time you're going to need a string is when you're going to print, and print obviously already converts to strings automatically. But it is possible you can convert to strings, you can convert to all sorts of other types. So that is the basics. Pay attention to this, because we will often find ourselves reading data from the user. We'll either be reading from a file on disk, or we'll be reading from the user actually typing on the keyboard. Whenever we read from the user, the data we're going to get, even if it has numeric contents, will be a string originally. We'll need to convert it to an integer by doing this. All right, hope that was clear. I'll see y'all later. Bye-bye.